How's it going, bros? My name is PewDiePie. We're playing Discord. It's supposed to be a game where your choices really, really matter for the outcome, and those games are usually really cool to watch and play for YouTube. So I'm like, all right, well, this looks cool. I'll check it out. I think we might even be able to finish it in one go. But yeah, my name is Rita. I'm a female. I was born 1 year younger than me. I don't know if this matters. I enjoy earplugs and quiet, uneventful flights. All right. Enjoy your trip. Okay. The path you forge are your own. Choose wisely. Bon voyage. Very interesting. I love games like this. It's a really cool art style too, I gotta say. So, yeah, and why don't you tag along for this hour or so, or how long this video is. I don't know yet. My brain... my brain feels like it went through a coffee grinder. It feels like I've been lying out here for hours. What is all this crap in the batch? Wait, a plane crash? But I was... Oh, no. Alright, stay calm, Rita. I am not calm, I'm totally freaking out. That's my seat, good old 221C. I wonder if things would have gone differently if I was in a window seat. Never pick window seats, bros. Ah! Sorry, I have a cold, so you're gonna get all about that disgusting shit. Yeesh, good thing I wasn't in that seat. There you go, that answers your fucking question. I don't know why, it reminds me a little bit of Little Big Planet. Or Tearaway, if you ever play that. No one play that game because it's on the Vita. Am I stuck already? No, I'm not. What the heck was a frying pan doing on a plane? They're closing in on us! Huh? What the heck was that? Can I swing my frying pan? That's all I want in life. That's all I wanted. I should go and check on that noise. Yeah. So that was a choice that might have a difference in the game. Oh my god. They're calling for backup! We totally surrounded. Make sure you aim for their eyes! It will scramble the chips in their brains! What the fuck you on about? It doesn't even matter, we're done for. Steve, somebody else is approaching! Steve's hair totally matches the crab's. I can appreciate a man who can match a haircut. She's probably here to feast on us, just like these crabs! Wait, are you talking about me? You're totally clueless, aren't you, Titty? Hey, lady! Now might be a good time to help us! Seriously, they're just crabs. How did this even happen? Alright, I'm coming. Well, they look like they're seriously in need, but I do want to answer the other ones. But alright, I'm coming. Alright, I'm coming.
I've got my trusty metal detector on me, but they will definitely attack if I pull it out!
That's what she said. Just get over...
Just get over here and help me!
What? No! Come here! What? Well, I might as well try to put this frying pan to good use. I'm going for this guy. Because... attacks crabs with frying pan. Attack. My god, so many choices! Take this, crabs! Oh shit, they're just getting angrier. Oh fuck! Oh shit!
Well, if... It sure got them to stop attacking me!
Oh man, these crabs are relentless. Look at his poor little legs. My legs are all torn up. This has just been a fantastic day. Alright, okay. Well, let's get back to camp. The others will want to meet. I didn't catch your name.
It's Rita!
No, it's Rita! Wait, there are Svevis? Yeah, they're farther inland. I'm Steve, by the way.
My name's Teddy.
Alright, let's get going. Alright. My voice is already dead. I'm sick. I should not be doing this. Are you ready to head to camp? Give me a minute. Fine, but try to make it quick. It's really interesting so far. So the point of this game is that it's supposed to be like really replayable.
Man, none of these weird plants and twigs looked edible. Even if they were, it doesn't look like they would taste very good.
I like how that dialogue is straight to point too.
What are you doing? What if the crabs are waiting for you in there?
Relax, I'm just looking around.
What the
fucks him up and the crabs, they'll just be waiting in the water.
Pitch plants, alright.
Whoa, there's metal and wreckage all over the beach. I'm glad I can't remember the crash. It must have been terrible.
Alright, let's go.
Don't you think it's a little risky to take the stranger back? What if she's just a bunch of crabs in a human suit?
That's just the risk we're gonna have to take.
Alright, we're going. I like the game so far. I don't know about you, Brass. It's really cool.
What? Look, another survivor.
What? I thought we were the only ones.
Heavens, Betsy, come have a seat.
Alright.
She must have been out of her ears. Are you alright? Yeah, I think so.
I like her glasses. Fucking pimp as shit.
That's no good. None of us seem to be in the clash.
What's your name? Rita. I'm Jolene. The lump over there with the mustache, that's my husband, George.
Howdy, how?
Online, I'm known as Netherlord90, but you could call me Garrett.
That's a badass name, man. I don't remember her voice, fuck.
He's been doing this he's been getting ahead of me. Where are we? None of us, but a ship is new and in.
The dead and pretty big. We have no clue what kind of stuff could be on the other side.
There's a mountain in the distance, but it's a long hike anyway. We have no idea what's over there.
We start making the best out of the situation. I got this fire built and we got started on some shelter.
Someone is calling me. The fuck? Sorry.
So far, all we get for food is a pile of pretzels from off the plane.
Great. Oh, great. The fucking boar stole our pretzels.
Jeez Louise and sweet cream cheese.
Oh no, those pretzels are our only food. Oh damn. Those are gonna be such a well-balanced meal for us. What if they're more than pigmas out there?
Rita, you come with George and me. Let's get this bear.
I don't think that's the best idea. It's not like we have weapons to hunt them.
My Georgie has his old fishing pole. He can twat them with that.
And I suppose you're gonna throw that bulky camera of yours at them?
Well, I'll do what needs to be done.
We need to stay here and defend the few sources we got left.
Come on, Georgie. We don't have time for this. I don't trust these headlooms. Rita, you ready? Let's go.
What should we do, Bruce? I wish I could hear you. I wish I was streaming this. I'm gonna start streaming this soon. I think it'll be fun. I like the background ambience music. It's very nice too. It seems dumb if you're trying to survive to just stay and protect. I don't think that's a good choice. But it seems kind of jumping right away to just go and do it. But yeah, let's go after it. I was just scratching my asshole there for a second, sorry.
Let's go get it. It's bacon making time.
Yeehaw!
Atta girl.
Wait, hold on a second. You know, you leave the three of them alone here.
Don't worry, you'll be fine.
Yeah, don't be such a fucking pussy.
What are we supposed to do if somebody attacks us here?
You're all as brave as a bear of soup. Defend the camp at all cost.
Yeah, right, like, it's that easy. Not without you learning, buddy.
I'm sure you'll manage. We'll be back before you know it anyway. George and Rita, let's get moving.
Finally. It's so annoying. There's three and three. I'm pretty sure they can do fine, alright? It'd be interesting to see how the story is different in the end. It would be cool if you bros play this and tell me what ending you got or something. I don't know.
There it is.
We need to be careful. It will run away again. Maybe I can stand it with my camouflage.
I got my trusty fishing pole. Too bad it broke in the crash. Might be able to hit him with it. Alright, what's the plan? That looks like a dildo, I'm sorry.
Hang on, I'm thinking.
Alright, so what should we do here? I feel like the flash is just gonna scare it away. Throw the pole is probably just gonna miss. Throw a frying pan, fuck yes.
Are you sure that's a good idea? Can you really throw it that far?
How's my voice acting, by the way? I think it's pretty impeccable. I think I can do it. Oh, maybe not.
Did you really think you were gonna hit the board with a frying pan?
Guess I'm just not as strong as I thought. Whoops. It's getting late. I think the hunt is a lost cause at this point.
Let's just get this shit back to our camp. Maybe the others have better news.
Aren't you gonna get your frying pan? Obviously. Alright, don't throw your frying pan, kids. Lesson learned.
More wreckage from the plane all the way out here.
Alright, let's go. Interesting. I'm really curious how this is gonna pan out. You know? Oh. Sorry. Oh my god, I knew they would be bitching. These guys are the bitch team. We should just get rid of them, you know? Sorry. What the fuck happened to his belly? Jesus Christ.
Finally! You guys should not have left us!
What happened here?
Oh yeah. There's definitely more than just one paw.
Yeah, I'll just bet it and what even happened.
More paws showed up. We needed everyone here. You should never listen to Jolene. We need her to stay together, Rita.
It's like they have a hive mind. It was part of a bigger plan.
Hey, they're pretty smart boars.
The first boar was just a distraction so the other could feast upon our flesh.
Jesus Christ, Teddy.
We tried to defend the camp, like you said. And? Garrett got sliced up pretty badly. He told us to do this, Rita. We could have been killed. Maybe I could have done more if my legs weren't all cut up from those crabs. What do you want me to do? Swing Teddy around my head and beat the birds away? But it doesn't look like you guys have brought up anything back.
It's my fault.
Doesn't matter whose fault it was. You failed.
We'll find something to marry.
Yeah, let's get some rest after a long tiring day of being useless. We need to protect these pretzels. We shouldn't just leave them out in the open.
Just dig them down or something. How fucking hard is... Thank you. How hard is it? Why didn't you just do that from the beginning? Oh, maybe I could. Oh, shit.
Anyway, we set up a bit of a shelter early this morning. Grab a torch, and we'll show you the shelter we made.
Grab a torch, you'd say. Alright, 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 I say. Beautiful art style, I fucking love it.
Wow, you guys actually put together a pretty decent shelter. All things considered. I guess this is our home for now, until we get rescued. This torch won't last forever, but I should have enough to talk to a few people. Let's talk to you first. What's your name?
Jolene. Huh. Alright, alright. This is going to be like the time George and I went camping on the beaches in South Africa.
That sounds like an adventure.
Oh, the stories I could tell. We spent many nights together in those stars like this.
Why don't you and George sleep next to each other?
Oh. That's what an odd question to ask.
I'm sorry, I shouldn't have.
No, it's okay, D. He has this awful snoring habit. I can't sleep near him.
Oh, I see.
You know, we could have killed that bow.
I don't think...
Why don't you leave the hunting to us country folk? And you stick to whatever it is you city folk do.
Yeah, you didn't say anything.
You didn't seem like to have any better ideas. I just didn't think you would be able to screw it up that badly.
What a fucking bitch. Alright. Teddy's just pissing me off. Let's talk to him.
Finding you on the beach was a surprise. We were pretty lucky we're there, I guess.
Yeah, it was oddly disorienting to wake up to.
Yeah. Teddy was looking to find some supplies on the beach. All we found was a horde of crabs.
And me.
Yeah, you may have been better off without this group. We don't bring a whole lot to the table.
A group beats being alone. I'm not sure how far my BFA and barista skills would get me out of here. If I hadn't met up with you guys, I might not even be this far.
Groups have never paid off in my experience.
Oh, come on now. The world isn't all that bad.
It isn't all that good either. Especially for a ginger.
Well, let's get some rest. This torch won't last that much longer. I could probably speak in one more shot.
Alright, I'm staying with these guys. I'm ready for a good night of sleep.
Yeah, we'll see how sleeping on the sand goes. I suppose we can't be too picky. Jolene mentioned that you snore really loudly in sleep. Is this something we should be worried about?
Oh, for it. It's not that bad. Jolene just started complaining about that recently. Maybe if you shave your huge ass fucking mustache, you can use that as a fucking shelter too.
It never used to be an issue for her. I don't know why it's such a big deal lately.
I see.
May, I'm sure we wish we could have gotten that bowl.
Yeah, that was a little harder than I expected.
What you expect? The thing is as big as you are.
Yeah, I'm glad we were able to do it.
Reminds me of my wrestling with my cousin back in the firm. I was younger than all of them. That didn't stop me from putting up a fight, though.
Did you ever win?
Once in a blue moon. Blue moon? What the fuck does that mean? Now that I think about it, though, they probably just let me win so I wouldn't quit.
This torch is too low. It's time for me to go to sleep.
Alright. It doesn't look very comfortable.
But I guess it will have to serve for the night. Might as well try and get some shut-eye.
I like my nose. It's all burned and shit. Well, that was some character development. I wonder if who I picked to... day two. Who to hang out with changes the stuff as well. I don't know. We played a lot of games with choices and shit, but honestly, in a lot of them, the outcome is usually the same, so it'll be interesting. But then you don't know what the... Ah, fuck it. Alright.
Huh. Looks like we have made it through the front lane. Lane. Yay.
I'm ready to get some things done today.
I don't think you should be doing anything today.
What? What do you mean?
All you did yesterday was leave things more difficult by leaving.
Well, I'm gonna help y'all. You might need me.
Fine, if you insist. I got a headache already without having to argue with you.
Maybe you planted something in your brain while you were asleep. What the fuck, Teddy? Shut the fuck up about your conspiracy theories. You're dead to me. He has 3 watches. That's kind of cool.
Which one of you was it? Speak up. I suspect Garrett.
Why me?
All right, guys. I think I just need some coffee.
Caffeine withdrawal? Makes me feel like I'm in college again. Drinking something usually helps.
Not salt water.
I'm going to check the wreckage for supplies. Maybe my string of bad luck will end.
I fucking love the ambience. I don't know why. It reminds me of... I don't know. Ah, fuck it.
Who knows? There may be some water from the plane as well.
We need a signal for help if we ever plan on being saved.
Yeah, I mean, if we recently crashed, there should be people looking for our plane, right? I think we need water first. That's like a survivalist thing. You can last long without food, but not without water. So let's go for that. Alright, I watched Naked and Afraid. I know a couple things.
If we don't find water that we can drink, we won't last very long. Well, why don't you see if there's a lake or something?
On a desert island? Them boys gotta be drinking something.
Why don't you take Garrett with you, Rita? He seems like he could use an adventure.
What? What?
Alright, you ready to go, Garrett?
I guess. I'll come with you as well. I'm no stranger to dealing with animals.
Alright, sounds good to me.
We're never gonna get off this island! Alright, this is ridiculous! I'll just stay back and watch the camp then.
Keep being positive, Teddy. Keep being positive. Okay, what do we got here? You know, it's too bad that my trusty fishing pole here got broken in the plane crash. If we actually found a pot or something, we could have gone fishing with it.
The only thing of mine that survived the crash was Game Brick.
His Game Brick?
I clung onto Bricket with my life. I don't know what I would do without her.
I like his mullet hair too.
That toy that is your laugh.
What? How dare you? Shh, it's okay, Bricky. The scary mustache man didn't mean it.
This guy is a survivalist for sure.
Alright guys, let's focus. We're here to find water.
It's hopeless. There's no water around here.
Let's not give up just yet. There's got to be some trace of water around here. Let's split up and search the vicinity.
Do you guys remember? I remember when I was a kid. Oh, it's dry now. You know when you hold one of the sticks that have like two exits on it and a front, and you use that to look for water? I never understood. Is that like a thing you tell kids to have them do something retarded or stupid? Or is it actually true? Like, how would it work? Would gravity be affected by the stick or some shit? No, wait, that doesn't make sense. Would the gravity affect it? I don't fucking know.
It's not so much cooler in the shade. I'm roasting out here.
That scarf probably isn't helping.
You're probably right, George. Ooh, boar tracks.
Those are anima tracks. They look pretty fresh, too.
Animals need to drink too, I bet. If we follow these, we find water.
That actually makes sense. Yeah. What? Well, then, come on, Garrett. I mean, worst thing. Oh, it worked! Awesome.
This water. Wait, I think I just saw something moving there.
I doubt it was anything. Garrett, why don't you get down there and scoop up some of that tasty, tasty water?
But now's your chance to prove yourself to the team.
Yeah, I guess.
I'll get some fucking water. Oh.
You guys keep a lookout. I'll get some water.
Sounds good to me.
Yeah, that's the thing. Oh my god, where did I get all these bottles from?
Oops. It looks like you got a few friends on you there.
Chris, there's leeches all over you.
Well, don't just stand here.
I'll get George.
George, can we get these leeches off me?
Yep. I'm coming. So if you get leeches on you, you're supposed to rub them, because that annoys them and they will just let go. I know, you little buggers. There you go. The more you know.
Survival repairs! Phew, looks like we got all of them.
Yeah, I volunteer at an animal shelter back home. I hate dealing with leeches and dicks. No wait, leeches and ticks. I love animals, but that stuff grosses me out.
Let's get ourselves and this water back to camp. Oh my god, I hope Garrett isn't gonna be a problem if we catch an animal. So, another thing. Oh, what do we got here? Fuck it. I think you have to boil the water to clean out
like an open water could just be filled with a bunch of bugs and diseases and fucking shit. Yeah, I'm ready. But I don't know. We'll see. I mean, we got a fire going. I think we're a pretty good team.
We got the water.
Holy crap. Garrett can actually pull his weight. I doubt anyone but me could have pulled that off. You didn't even do anything. What the fuck? Rita, George, and I fought violently in our battle for assistance. It doesn't matter. We got it. We just may last for a day or two longer now. Anyway, here. Everybody should take a drink.
But we only have three. Can't we just fucking share it? Oh, okay. We're passing it around.
Oh, I see you didn't bring anything back, Steve. Actually, I think we found something. But I need some help getting to it. A lot of that wreckage was too heavy for me to lift.
Well, maybe we can look into it tomorrow.
I'm telling you guys, we need to try to make contact with the outside world.
Maybe, Teddy. But there's a lot of stuff we have to do if we want to stay alive. If we make head, we make it. Let's get some breath.
Coming from you, you fat fuck. No, I'm just kidding. No fat shaming.
I'll grab a torch. We should find our way over to the tent.
Are we gonna talk to people again like we did yesterday? Seems like it. It's really interesting so far. I hope we're gonna make it. I wonder if you can fail. I bet you can. Alright. Should we talk to this asshole? I'm telling you! We need to come up with a way to signal passing boats and things!
Maybe we can get around to that tomorrow.
The longer we wait, the more opportunities we may miss.
You're right. I suppose that makes sense. We will have to take care of it tomorrow.
Good! I'm glad you're seeing it my way!
Now, get some rest.
I concur! Alright, let's talk. I want to hear about the wreckage. What is it?
Sure. Would be good if we could get that stuff off from under that wreckage.
Maybe George can do it. He worked on a farm.
Yeah, maybe. Well, I'm gonna go sleep it off.
I don't like that bitch. Let's talk to him.
So, you and Jolene travel a lot?
Oh yes, she loves to travel.
Only her?
Oh, well, I didn't mean... I really don't mind it. I do miss the safety of home when I'm gone. I do it for Jolene, though.
You two must really love each other.
Well, yes. Yes, we do.
Why the hesitation?
Oh, I don't know. Things have been different lately.
I'm sure you'll figure it out.
I don't like getting into other people's business. Come on.
You're a great couple.
I sure hope so. I'm sure that it's nothing. I'm just being a little paranoid. Maybe getting stuck on this island will be good for us. We can have a simple life away from everything for a while.
You love each other, George.
You love each other.
like a shipper on Tumblr.
You love each other.
I'm sure you figure it out.
Maybe you're right.
Yeah.
I need some rest. Have a good night, Rita.
For sure.
All right. Time to get some shut-eye. Thank God I have this water. These fucking voices are killing me. Day 3. Alright, alright, alright. You still in it? You still in it to win it, bros? Say ayo. Wow, that was so cool. Really.
One more night down. I'm gonna need to stretch my legs and move around.
What, you have legs? Holy shit. I didn't see them. You're right. Sure would be nice to take a walk.
I'm starting to get pretty hungry.
We're going to go days without food. Just stay strong.
Can we focus here? We have to figure out what we're doing today.
Well, yesterday we were able to collect some water, so that will help a lot.
Jolene and I would like an extra helper to go check on that plane wreckage. There might be useful supplies in there.
No, We need to find a way to signal the outside world. Maybe there's a radio in the wreckage. Come on. I'll go with the plane. Rita, you said last night that you thought building the signal was priority. I changed my mind, Teddy. I don't think making a signal is that important. Ah, fine. Go play around in the wreckage with Steve.
I come too. Judge Day, stay here and keep an eye on Gary.
If you say so, honey. Seriously? You'll sit here and camp, but you won't help me build a signal?
We got to conserve our energy, Teddy. We don't have much to go on.
I absolutely cannot believe this. Guess I'll be saying I can too.
Alright, everybody. Let's get a move on.
Why? They should be able to build a fucking signal. Come on, man. That was just a convenient plot thing.
Sure is crazy to see all of this. It's hard to believe that anyone could survive that.
Why were you on the plane?
I was nominated to compete in an international Laddie Art Champion. Are we playing as a hipster? What the fuck?
Wait. So what do you do for a living?
I normally work as a barista at a local coffee shop.
Sounds better than my job. I'm just a professional ginger.
Going to college hasn't really paid off yet.
Yeah, it's hard to say.
If you ask me, college ain't even worth it.
Nobody asks you.
Whoa, sassy.
Well, I'm just gonna say my George never went to college. He takes me on vacations multiple times every year.
That's really great, Jolene. That's why you're here, you know, you fucking bitch.
Steve, were you on some business trip or something?
Well, I was forced to go on vacation by our staff therapist.
A forced vacation? That doesn't sound so bad.
Yeah, well, I threw a stapler across the office at my boss.
And you didn't get fired?
I was given the "you're a valuable asset to the company" speech. They still neglected to promote me, though. Life is strange. That would make a good paperweight. What does that mean? What's a paperweight?
Why do you have to stop and look at every single plant you come across, D? Us city folk don't get to see nice flowers that often.
Okay. Let's get to business. What do we got? Some glass could be useful.
Why does it always ask if I'm ready when I obviously looked everywhere, didn't I? Alright.
There's probably some useful stuff laying around in here.
That piece of metal there, why don't you see if you can lift it?
That was fucking easy. Oh.
It's way too heavy. Jolene, get over here and help me.
Yeah, with those fucking man muscles. Holy shit.
Nice. You guys are pretty strong.
You probably shouldn't stay underneath when you're saying that. Okay.
Well, it comes with working on the farm all of years. Do they teach that in the cottage of yours? Actually.
Alright, let's focus, guys.
Just start looking for supplies or whatever.
Oh, I think I see something over there.
Oh, dynamite!
Oh, awesome. It's a box of emergency flares. This will be useful. Weird. It kind of smells like alcohol over here.
Oh my goodness! That ain't alcohol, it's yet fuel.
Steve! Oh shit!
Your cigarette!
No! Steve!
I'm surrounded!
Stay where you are! I'll think of something.
We don't have a lot of time here, Rita.
I know.
Aw, man. Maybe this is it for old Steve.
We'll get you out.
Don't worry, Steve. We're gonna get you out of there. Jolene, let's try and push over some of the wreckage so Steve can climb across. The tail of the plane over there might work.
Oh yeah, that might actually work. Never mind.
Crap, everything's falling apart. I can't believe it stayed standing like this for many days. We got to find something else.
No, Jolene. There's no point in trying to fight fate now. Guess I'm never going to achieve my lifelong goal of getting just one damn race.
Is the rain gonna stop?
Wait. It's raining? Oh man, this is fantastic. The world's not done with me yet, Rita. You know what? I feel great. My legs are newly cut. Being that close to death made me realize how beautiful life really is. That's right. No more overworking myself. And no more smoking. From now on, I'm a new man. I'm invincible!
Steve! Oh man. Oh my god. Did that seriously just happen? I'm starting to think Teddy has the right idea. Either Steve has the worst luck ever, or there's something else involved here.
Don't be ridiculous, really.
This is ridiculous! The way that lightning went right for Steve, it may have time to go. There's nothing we can even do to prevent it. Eventually, we're all going to die out here. Just like Steve. It sucks. It's not like I knew him that well, but he's still one of us.
Just tell me something when my dad that made me feel a lot better. Now how'd that go again?
Oh, that's right. He told me not to linger on her death, because my ma loved every day of her life. She died surrounded by her friends and family, happier than a pig in a mud. Actually, now that I said that out loud, it doesn't really seem to apply to Steve, does it?
No, not at all. Well,
at least he's not stuck on this dang island anymore.
Sure, Jolene. I guess that's one way to look at it.
Let's just get back to camp. We're not doing too well, are we, bros? So, we got some supplies, but we lost one of our members. I don't know if there was a way to save him, I'm curious.
Hey, Rita. I see you're still in one piece.
Wait a second! Where's Steve?
He had an accident and... Steve...
Was Steve abducted by... aliens?
No. We were searching the wreckage and there was a fire from the jet fuel. Steve got trapped by the fire, and there was lightning and...
Oh, a black mage is casting spells.
I bet he... Somebody's controlling the weather to make our task harder!
No.
Would you listen? Steve is dead!
No. Steve is just gone.
Struck by lightning, you see? Sounds to me like a little more than just karma is at work here.
Steve went down with honor.
We were able to find this box of flares in the wreckage. May be useful, I suppose.
While you guys were off wandering around, I decided to have a look down the beach. But the crabs are at the beach. Are you crazy? I noticed there was a light offshore. There's definitely someone out in the water.
Really? That's great. Maybe we can build something to get out to it.
Maybe? I don't know. None of it matters. What a signal. We're gonna go die out here.
What's going on, Teddy?
Nobody's listening to me! We have to find a way off this island.
Teddy, I'm sure they know the plane went down. I bet they're looking for us right now.
Why would anyone understand? Things like this don't happen! We're being tested!
Teddy, I think you're being ridiculous.
You don't get it!
Calm down, Teddy.
They're deciding which one of us to keep. Well, I'm not going to be the one that's disposed of.
Alright, Teddy. Maybe you're right. We all have a lot to deal with.
Maybe we should continue this over by the tents where we can keep dry.
Right. I'll grab a torch.
Why am I the only one capable of grabbing fucking torches? Although I really do like the art style. I've said it many, many times. How the hell did we even get a fire going? We can't even do shit.
The rain is quickly getting worse.
It's really cold.
Well, the shed is keeping it pretty dry right now.
It's a lot colder out in the rain.
Teddy's not even in the shelter. Look at him. He's so fucked.
We'll make sure it. We'll make it through the night. We can find something better after the storm tomorrow.
Why do that when we can leave?
That's the dumbest thing I ever heard. Where would we even go?
Inland. We can find better shelter. Maybe there's something somewhere where that the water won't get in.
We could get lost in the storm and never find our way back. We could also get hypothermia and die.
I think it's a bad idea to wait until morning. Then we can look for better shelter.
Rita! You're being pretty kind. Don't have me on their side.
We should stay here. It's too soon to abandon this site. Let's tough it out here for the night.
What? No!
Give it up, Titty. We're staying.
My side of the tent is all soggy. If we're going to do my idea, somebody should switch spots with me.
If we aren't going to do my idea.
None of our spots are exactly prime real estate, Titty. Just suck it up and take what you got.
Why don't you switch side with me then, George?
Just go to sleep.
Stop arguing. We'll just sleep in our own spots.
Yeah, Titty. Just go to sleep.
I'm tired of Teddy and his bitching, alright?
Well, good night, everybody.
This is looking so shit. I mean, people are still looking for the fucking wreckage, right? We should stay close to it. We have water, we have fire, there's wildlife. I think it's pretty good. But apparently not.
Oh no.
What? Oh shit. Oh fuck, I forgot about that.
Guys. Hey guys.
Everyone wake up!
What are you going on about?
Oh my goodness, flood water!
Looks to be a storm surge coming in. We best get ourselves out of here.
Oh, well, he's fucking dead. Ouch! That's the appropriate word.
Are you alright, Titty?
She's standing in the fucking water! I think I'll be fine, but I can't seem to move. Oh shit, he's gonna drown.
It's too dark. I can't see what's going on. Rita, get us a new torch from the fire so we can shed some light on the situation. I'm on it.
Crabs.
Oh.
All of our supplies are washing away.
Alright, I'm coming. We're gonna lose the supplies. We can find more. We have to get out of here.
It seems cruel to leave someone to die because supplies are washing away, even though it's probably not the right decision.
Get that light in here, Reedy.
I see it now. Your leg is stuck behind the branch here. When I say lift, we lift. Lift.
Bam. Save your ass.
There we go, you're free.
Alright, let's go.
Let's get out of here. I saw some rocks more inland. Maybe we can find some shelter underneath them.
Alright, that actually sounds pretty fucking nice. Sounds like a pretty swell idea. I'm gonna have to take a break here. Okay, let's continue. We're doing shit. Hey, life is life. We found a cave. That's good. That's actually amazing. Look at that. What? This is an awesome... Yeah.
Whoa, this cave is awesome. What if there's a treasure buried in here or something?
I really doubt there's treasure. This could be pretty good protection from the storm, though.
Reminds me of my basement.
The reminiscence.
I haven't seen a storm like this in some time.
Well, let's try and get some sleep. If we're lucky, this cave won't flood. Alright, 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 alright.
Day four.
What do you bros think? Are we gonna make it out alive? I'm not so sure.
I'm exhausted. That was not the greatest night of sleep I ever had.
Looks like there's some of the rainwater collecting in the puddles here. That's convenient. That is actually drinkable water.
I've always slept better in streams, but there's something beautiful about nature cleansing itself.
The sound of rain is usually peaceful, but I'm finding it difficult to think that way right now.
This music is beautiful.
Oh, we need to get our campfire going again. The torch is almost out.
Yeah, that'd be terrible. Oh shit, we don't have dry wood now.
I'll see if there's any dry wood in here. I'll be right back.
What the fuck is this glowing thing? Are those mushrooms? Let's just eat them and get high. Don't do that, Bruce.
I can never remember which are stalagmites and which are stalactites?
Hashtag relatable? Oh, this looks useful.
Here's one. I think we need a bit more, though.
Where?
This cave is actually pretty nice. It probably saved our lives. Glowing mushrooms? Pretty sure you're not supposed to eat anything that glows.
Well, have you tried to eat a unicorn's app?
Why wouldn't you eat anything like glows? That's bullshit. Don't listen to her. Ah, here we go.
Hopefully, this will get a good blaze going.
Good work, Rita.
Can we do something about food? I'm starving here. I'm sick and tired of his fucking complaining.
Hold on. At least let me get the fire going first.
There you go, beautiful.
What? Kitty!
Wait a second, did anyone hear that?
Look, there's a cat over there. Kitty! Meow? What's a cat doing in here anyway?
It's hiding from us. It must be afraid.
Until we can confirm it's organic, we should assume it's a Rican drone. I agree, Teddy. I agree.
We could just wait and let it come to us. It's probably scared.
Why don't we just try and grab it? Might be nice having company.
Wait.
Let's wait for it to come to us. You sure? What if it went as right and getting in trouble?
We'll just wait for it.
It's fine. We'll just wait and see what happens.
I'm telling you, this is a bad idea. The cat is full of computer chips and spy data.
I agree with Rita.
Alright, let's just leave it. Fucking idiots, we have bigger priorities than fucking pussy right now. I never thought I'd say those words. Things aren't looking good for us, are they? It's been a stressful few days.
Maybe we should all take a break, spend some time to try and calming our nerves. We can take a quick nap and then this evening we'll deal with food problem.
As much as I'd like to do something more productive, a bit of an actual rest wouldn't go amiss right now. Nap time. That's an idea I can get behind.
Just try and relax. Our mental health can be just as important as our physical health. We'll talk more in a few hours.
What, didn't we just sleep? Aw, kitty!
Oh, look. It's that cat from before.
Meow.
Ah, there you go, little guy.
You can stick with us from now on.
Okay, great. So we got a stupid cat now.
It's not stupid.
It even has a name tag.
Mr. Whiskers. How nice. Okay, now... No, you're right. That's pretty stupid. I'm gonna give it a new name.
I'll consult the random cat name application on my game rig.
Genius. I can't wait to see what it comes up with.
You shall now be known as Kai.
Okay. We got more important things to deal with right now.
We really need to talk about food. We've been on this island for days and we have nothing to eat.
There isn't really anything we can do about it. We can't venture out due to the storm.
I'm so hungry.
Oh no, fuck you. We're not eating the cat. I don't give a fuck what you're saying. I guess there's nothing we can do about this. Teddy, can I talk to you in private for a second?
Okay. But don't try anything funny. Remember, I know Kung Fu. Thank you, Teddy. Just come over here. It won't take long.
What are they going to talk about?
I wonder what this is all about. Poor boy. Probably just scared. We've been through a lot. Who cares what this is about? It's just Garrett. Shh. They're coming back.
Look at that cat. It's so cute.
Sorry about that, everyone.
Yes? Apologies for taking so long. Yeah, no, that was about 2 full seconds. I can't believe it. Now, where were we?
Well, it doesn't really matter. There's nothing to eat. All we have is this fire. Nothing left to do until we decide to go to sleep, I guess.
Oh, the mushrooms. Is that an option? Are we gonna eat the mushroom? What are we gonna do? The mushrooms go through my body. Wow, amazing. Wow. Am I just supposed to talk to them? Let's talk to Teddy. Well, let me... Why did I talk to Teddy? Let me guess. You want to know what Gary talked to me about?
No, I don't care.
Well, too bad. Wait, what? If you don't have anything to say, just leave me be. Wow, asshole. Let's talk to the kitty then.
Meow.
If you'd like a bite to eat, I'd like to give you a bite of eat if I could, but we're a little strapped on supplies right now. If you can hunt down a mouse or something, you'd be eating better than we are, honestly.
Meow.
Let's talk to him. Yeah, really sucks that we have no food.
What were you doing just now with Teddy?
That's personal, alright? That's why I wanted to keep it private. It's your fault I got attacked by the boar while I was defending camp out here in the first place.
Come on, what an asshole! Fucking neckbeard son of a bitch.
Ever since then, I've had a hard time trusting you. Probing isn't going to help you right now.
Asshole.
I'm so hungry. I hope we can find some food, Amara.
Me too. I've never been this hungry in my life.
No sense complaining about it anymore. We should just try and rest.
Yeah, you're right. Garrett and Teddy sure were acting suspicious yesterday.
Yeah, I wonder what they were doing.
Part of me doesn't even want to know. Some things are better left unsaid, you know.
You might be right about that.
Okay, we talked to everyone. Oh, the kitty goes to sleep too. The kitty's so cute.
Day 5. Holy shit. I don't like where this is going, Russ. I really, really, really don't.
Looks like we survived another night. Things are looking up.
How is that looking up?
It's possible we're already dead. And this is some kind of purgatory.
Quit yammering about nonsense. Stuff like that is only happening in TV shows.
It sounds like the storm has finally ended.
Well, there's a bit of good news. Kinda seems happy enough. Maybe things are going to be okay. If we don't eat soon, we're going to have to real big problem. Our goal today has to be to go find something to eat.
So, who's going to go out searching? I feel way too weak after going so long without food.
Yeah, well, I think I could probably manage.
Really? You sure?
Yeah, just leave it to me.
I don't trust those two. I'll come with you, Garrett. I bet they're in love. I bet they're fucking making out in some shit.
You love each other. Yeah, you do.
Those two seem just a bit too energetic. Oh well, I shouldn't complain about them volunteering to go out. I still feel pretty weak. I guess I'll just hang out here until they return.
What's going on? They came back. Okay, cool.
Hey, I'm back!
I fell asleep. I feel so weak. I need to eat something. Wait, where's Gary?
Gary's gone, I'm afraid. We were foraging in these bushes. We found some edible nuts.
Whose edible nuts, exactly?
Enough for all of us. Then a jaguar just came out of nowhere. I barely got away.
a jaguar in the desert? Karen wasn't so lucky. I'm glad that jaguar didn't try to follow me. Oh god. What the fuck? I can't believe this. I thought I lost it. We need to make a distraction quick.
Flash your camera.
Jolene, use your camera. Hey, kitty.
Oh shit, Jolene's gonna get fucking eaten. Oh fuck. Sorry, Jolene. Use the fire.
I can't get away. We need to help Jolene.
I'll save you, Jolene.
No! George! No!
We need to get out of here.
Aww. George!
I can't believe that jaguar killed George. I hate this damn island. So much for that cave, it's obviously not a safe place. Let's get head back to our original camp and regroup there.
Jolene, you don't seem upset.
Good thinking. Let's go.
I love how the cat is following us.
Yikes. Our camp is in terrible shape after that storm. It's a good thing we left for the cave when we did, otherwise we'd be all toast. We're lucky to be standing here right now.
We still have to have these nuts that Teddy and Garrett found. Everyone should eat some while we have the chance. This food is a godsend.
You're kidding me. It's no home cooking, but it's gonna hit the spot.
Yeah.
Good protein.
If only we had a few spices, I could make this taste even like heaven.
I'm sure you would, Jolene.
With a few spices, I can make a cow pie taste like an apple pie.
Gross.
We've been on this island for 5 days now. I have to do something.
Let's just enjoy our food for now.
I don't think it will be that difficult.
We can deal with this tomorrow. There's no reason to ruin the moment. You should start getting ready for bed. Normally I grab a torch from the fire, but I guess we're going to bed by the moonlight tonight. Man, I'm tired. I shouldn't stay up too long.
I'm really curious how this is gonna end. I hope the cat makes it. That's all I care about at this point.
Hey, Jolene.
Oh, now she tells it.
I miss my dear so much.
I can't imagine losing somebody that I had right next to me for most of my life. That must be so painful.
I never felt more pain in my life.
Just remember, you always have to lean more me to lean on.
It's good to have you around now that Jesus came.
Well, I only wish I could do more. He was a good man.
Yes. Yes, he was. Well, I'll get some peace.
Alright. Good night, Jolene.
I don't even want to talk to him. I like my blue hair. Fucking cool as shit.
I think this island is trying to kill us.
Calling all terrestrial beings, we submit. Take us to your leader.
We need to try and come up with a way to get off this island. What are you suggesting, B? Maybe you need to accept or we might never get busy.
I refuse to believe that we're stuck here.
We're going to find a way off this island. I need to make another latte. I'm assuming you're planning to contact the aliens?
That's not the idea, Teddy.
Then what is it?
Think, Rita. Think.
Wait a second. What about...
The offshore light. What about the light that we saw out in the water?
We can make a raft or something and try and get out to it. We have no idea what that is! It could just be a shiny rock or something!
We should do this. Doing nothing isn't going to save us.
I think this is a good plan. I'm game to give it a try.
Alright. I suppose it's worth an attempt.
It's settled then. We need to make a raft and find a way out to that light.
Zoom in on Kitty? Oh, man. Oh, we look pretty fucked, man. I like this music.
Is this how we dance in Sweden?
Just make a purr face and move our fingers. That's all people need to know.
This beach looks like a good place as any to build the raft. Maybe some of this wood and debris could be of use. Someone should look for useful supplies while the others work on the raft. I like to stay behind and work on the raft. Who wants to search for supplies?
You seem to know what's going on. Why don't you just pick who does what?
Okay then.
Well, both of you find supplies.
I'm pretty sure I can handle the raft by myself.
Okay, I'll be watching you, so don't try anything funny.
So long, Red Eddie. Good luck with the raft.
Fine, now I'm alone with the kitty. I really gotta fucking pee. What's going on? What happened? What is this? Oh, nice. Konega.
Phew, that's pretty intense. At least the raft is finally complete. I know the raft isn't perfect, but I did the best I could by myself. What the heck happened to the supply run, though?
Had a help, but I twisted my poor ankle and had to sit down.
Oh no, what happened?
I was looking for supplies when I saw a great picture opportunity.
I was walking over to line up the shot when I slipped and ripped my ankle.
I was unable to find anything myself because my talents were needed elsewhere.
Sorry, what?
If you must know, I spend much of the day investigating some very suspicious rock formations. Using my metal detector, I scanned the surrounding area. I was hoping to find surveillance equipment by being used to spy on us.
So, what did you find?
Well, nothing. But they were very suspicious rock formations.
It's starting to get late. We should think about heading back to camp. We can get a full night's sleep and depart in the morning.
Beautiful raft, by the way. It looks stunning. I'm sure we won't drown at all. All I'm saying, if Kitty dies, I quit.
Our old camp is in great shape, and we lost our fire. But I guess it'll do for one more night. Hey there, Rita.
Hi, Jolene.
I've been wondering, what do you miss about home?
Well, for our 5th anniversary, George made a big old wooden rocking chair.
That's so sweet.
I don't care.
I have no idea. You have no idea how much I miss my George. Alright, shut the fuck up, Jolene. Shut the fuck up, bitch.
Let's just go to sleep. I'm tired of that fucking asshole. I feel like I fucked up since the beginning. Like, this is going so badly.
Okay, here we go.
So long, Alan. Perhaps we'll meet again.
Let me just talk to Kitty first.
Kai, do you want to come with us?
I think that's a yes.
Okay then, welcome aboard, Captain.
Alright, let's get this ship moving. We got a job to do.
I'm glad one of us is confident.
Back up, Rita.
It'd be fine. And if we went, we wouldn't have to turn Ruby.
That's what I'm worried about.
I sure hope the aliens don't notice us leaving. Why don't you just die already? We're going to be vulnerable out there.
Even if there are aliens, I doubt they care about a few people stuck on an island.
Are you kidding? They could pick us up and nobody would even notice. We're perfect test subjects. Aliens are smarter than you think, Rita.
Okay, Teddy.
That actually makes sense. I'm not even kidding.
Okay, guys. Let's get out of here.
Is that even a raft? Oh, the cat is so cute. Oh, it looks like it works.
Fucking hell.
This is a bad idea.
What are you talking about?
I made some calculations. Our odds of survivals are rather low.
It's a little late to be speaking up now, Teddy. Are you kidding me? Teddy, why didn't you do this on the beach?
Well, I had to factor in the systematic extraterrestrial evasion algorithm.
Oh my god.
And what, with only sand to ride in, it took a while to reinstallate the fucking hell.
You're just dumb, Teddy. Shut your trap.
No, but you're not listening. Rita, listen.
I will?
Just trust me. I subtracted the...
Actually, right now, I'm pretty sure you're not saying anything useful. My instinct tells me that we're going to be fine.
I like the music.
It's proven that human instinct has developed over time due to our dependencies upon technology.
Devolved. That's nice, Teddy.
My god, I hate Teddy. I hope he dies.
Not even kidding. Well, I hope this goes well. We're on our own here now. Yeah, if something goes wrong now, no one will ever find us. We're so far from everything.
I wouldn't worry too much about that.
What are you talking about, Teddy?
Well, it seems like we're alone, but you're forgetting about the nannies.
Alright, Teddy, I'll humor you. What are nannies?
What? You don't know about this? They're microscopic robots. Oh my god, I can't. Just shut up.
I'm so tired of Teddy. You have no idea. Day 8? Holy shit, I didn't think it would last this long.
I don't see the light source anymore. Hopefully the sunshine is just making it harder to see the light. Do you think it's even a good idea to keep going? I think we're going to be fine. We should try and fishing while we're out here. We have to do something so that we don't starve.
That sounds like a good idea to me.
With any luck, we'll be eating like lords and ladies.
If anyone suggests eating the cat, I will cut your throat. Oh, we found some fish.
Looks like I'm the only one of us who had any luck.
That's not entirely true, okay?
Kai caught up something little too.
And then promptly ate it.
At least our pet won't starve. Meow.
That's not what I meant.
Come on, guys. I think it's pretty good considering I was just scooping stuff up in a frying pan of all things.
Well, you're the only one of us who managed to catch anything. Naturally, you'll be eating one of these. Question is, who eats the other one?
Well, that sure as hell isn't fucking Teddy.
Are you giving it to me?
Yes, eat it, Jaleen. If you weren't complaining all the time, Teddy, maybe I'd be nice to you. You're just making everything harder. She lost her fucking husband.
Wow, we're getting really close. Wait, it looks really small.
I guess we're gonna find out. Here it comes. I wonder what it is. Oh shit.
Oh man, I can't believe he came all this way for a stupid boy.
Why don't we just go ahead and do some damage to it then?
What? Why would we do that? Wait, if it's broken, maybe people who run it will come and fix it.
Let's bust this thing.
Take that, frying pan.
That ought to do it. I guess we have to turn back now. We can't last out here waiting if we're starving. Let's push off this boy and head back.
That sounds terrible.
We need to be careful while we're sailing.
What do you mean? It's not like there's a whole lot we can do out here.
Well, we need to be paying attention to the water.
What are you taking me, Titty?
There were obviously people on the island at some point.
And what does that have to do with anything?
That means that there's about 84% chance that there are mines in the water.
What? There's no way.
Oh my god, I can't even...
Well, let's be glad we choose the raft method then.
Alright, it's time to sleep. How are we not dead yet?
That was a rough nay.
Oh, thank God.
Teddy's not getting up.
Oh no. After all this time, he just couldn't handle hunger anymore.
Hey, how it feels. There's something we could have done differently.
Now that we broke that boy, I'm sure someone is on their way to investigate. All we have to do now is wait. Uh-oh. Sharks. Is Teddy seriously dead? Uh-oh, it's storming up again. I feel like I keep seeing shark fins in the water.
Just hold on. Make sure you keep balance.
Hey, is that a helicopter?
It is! I can't believe it!
I'm gonna pass right overhead. We need to do something. Help! Down here!
It is.
I don't think they noticed us. If only we had those flares.
Maybe they headed for the island. If we can make it back there, we might still be able to meet up with them.
You're right. Let's not lose hope just yet. Incoming! Oh shit. Well, Ted is dead. Kitty! Kitty!
This isn't good. We need to get away from that shark.
Sorry. Hold on. Whoops! Oh shit. I'm all alone out here. What am I gonna do? No! Did Kitty die? Kitty Kai! Kitty Kai! Oh, thank God, Kitty Kai.
I'm back on the island. What happened? I'm still alive. That's the first bit of luck I had in a long time. That helicopter that passed over us at sea. It must have been heading here to the island. I hope it hasn't already passed by.
Not the fucking crabs.
I need to get away. Crap. Nobody run.
Don't fail me now, frying pan.
I'm outnumbered. This doesn't look good. I think I'm done for. What the? Kitty! We did it, Kitty! We made it out! It's a helicopter! I can hardly believe it. I don't think I'd ever get out of here alive. But this is really happening. Goodbye, Alan.
What the fuck? Everything just happened so quickly. Alright, we made it. There it is. Lone survival found after Dias Air Flight 404 crash. Just one survivor found after the accident. Will not comment at this time. Oh, they both died. Oh. They were pissed off about the vandalization. We have zero tolerance policy when it comes to vandalism. We opened a coffee shop together. Oh, that's adorable. Monument erected outside Area 51 for lost conspiracy theorist. One of the greats. Oh, we went to... They have the college if I... Oh. So they help me get to college? Fallen gamer honored in world's largest virtual memory service. He was a really cool dude, fellow guild member, Fat Dame. There it is. So you can share the screenshot with other people. And here are the people who made it. Alright. Start a new game to explore how different choices change your story. I'm really tempted to do that right away, but I don't have time to do more. If you bros play this or want to play it, leave a comment and tell me what outcome you got. That'd be really interesting. I feel like I got the most generic one. Like, just me surviving, you know? I wonder if you can save everyone. That'd be cool. Alright, bros. Had a lot of fun playing this game with you bros today. It was a good chill-out session, you know? Hope it wasn't too boring. I don't know. Bros, thank you for watching. I always appreciate it. And as always, I'll see you in the next one. Stay awesome, bros.